All right, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can import and export assets in Undertale Mod Tool. The process is going to be somewhat straightforward if you follow my steps. Now, first, I'm just going to show you how to do it the long way, so I can give you an idea of why it's being done the way I'm doing it. So if I were to want to, let's say I want to alter this sprite of a plate. Currently, the sprite is very, very small. It's just a sprite of a teeny tiny plate. And we export that. Let's just say we want to change the sprite's color so that it's red. We'll just do that real quick. We color this. Oh no, it's hardness, not tolerance. Alright, there. Good enough. And now to actually bring that sprite back into our data.win file is going to be quite a process if we want to do it manually. First off, we're going to go follow this texture page item, which itself is linked to this embedded texture group, right? So we have to export this entire texture. As you can see, there's quite a lot on this texture sheet, and our plate is going to have a specific position. It's going to be, pardon me, I have to locate it real quick. It's going to be over here. You'll notice there's some random junk around it. Don't worry about that. That's just how it looks. And we edit it so that it's now using our modified sprite. Save that. Import. Oh wait, sorry, back. And I can see our red plate is right there. And now we can go to our plate and see that it's now red as well. That's how you would do it manually. Now, of course, I made that look almost a little bit fast. Not quite speedy, but remember, you would have to do this for each and every sprite that you wanted to change. So you would have to, A, you would have to know which texture page it was in. B, you'd have to know where it was in that page. You would have to do it for each and every single one. Remember the exact positions for all of them. Make sure nothing ever misaligned. And of course, if you were making new sprites, you'd have to pack them so that they never overlapped. And that's just a very, very long and complicated process. Now, fortunately, you don't have to do that by hand. And you have right here these different scripts, which are in the top left, the section called scripts. Now what we're going to be looking at are the unpack assets and repack assets scripts. So first we'll just run this script to unpack assets just to show you what comes out. We're going to be running export all sprites.csx. That's going to take a minute to show up. And it's just going to export them one by one. I'll cut ahead here to after this is done and I can show you what the result looks like. Alright, now we can see that that process finished and it gives us this export path. It will just automatically send it to the same directory your game is installed at. I really should rewrite that script slightly so it doesn't do that, but that's for later. So if we were to go to that now, we just have to pull that up and we see this file called export sprites, and it's going to have literally every single sprite in the game individually. And this is very, very useful because now you can just open, you can just search in Windows whatever sprite you want, open it in here, and just edit it as you wish. Now, I exported it padded, but you should not do that in general. So the way you import sprites is you use the repack script, and there's several different ways you can do this. If you want to just, if you have a whole bunch of sprites like we have in that folder, you can do, hold on. Ah, here it is. It's called import graphics full repack.csx. And this script will, it's phrased a bit wrong, I'll have to edit that as well. It will import all valid sprites from all subdirectories. If you do not want this to occur, please click no to cancel the script. we'll click nope since we don't actually wish to do that, and we'll just pop that up. But instead, if we want to do something more simple, we just apply basic graphics mod. We'll just make a folder real quick. And a quick note about this, for your sprite, you need to have actually a frame number as well, so export all frames won't give you this if it's just a single frame sprite, but we have to add it for the script to work. So in this case, it'll be frame 0. The first frame is always going to be frame 0. That's something you should keep in mind, is that if we start counting things in general, they are going to start at 0 and not at 1. There's a few exceptions, but that's the general rule you should remember. And that would import it all the same. Actually, let's change it back to blue so I can demonstrate that. Wrong, that's right. Wrong. Okay, we'll try that again. And you can see that it actually changed color to match our new sprite. Now, apply graphics mod is more simple. It cannot handle if you add a new sprite to the game. It only replaces sprites that are already present in the game. And there are some similar scripts. You can, sprites are the more involved ones, but you also have scripts for exporting stuff like sounds. Code is also another one. You can export fonts. Backgrounds as well, I believe, are here. I don't see them right now. And you can export some other stuff like shader data. And you can also repack all these things. Repacks tend to be a little bit more complicated since you have more options here, but that's the basic gist of what you need to know. And there's a few other scripts that I'm going to be adding soon, which I've developed myself. So, for example, if I go to testing here, we have this script called export game objects, and it will actually allow us to do something quite interesting where it will actually export every single game object as a JSON file, and I'm going to be adding this again to the main thing very, very soon. And it already finished. It's very, very fast. I haven't even bothered to add a loading bar because it just finishes like that. And this is literally every game object in the entire game. This doesn't include the actual code entries like we talked about in episode 1. Those are considered code items, so it only stores what they're named and nothing else. So it's just a reference, sort of. But it stores them all the data for every single one. So that's very, very useful. I have another one for rooms. I would have to quickly locate that. I think that's on my desktop. Yes. And so now we want to try doing that again. I'll make a new folder. Temp 2. And that, again, finished very, very quickly because it's really just this sort of textual data almost. Rooms are actually very, very complex compared to game objects. There's a lot going on just because they have so much stuff. They've been around for so long. And that's really, I also made some matching import scripts, but that's going to be coming to the repository very soon, so that'll soon be included with these scripts. Right now it isn't, it's just on my computer exclusively, but it will be in the future. And that's really all you need to understand about these scripts. These scripts aren't really very complicated. You can even write your own if you kind of know what you're doing. These are just C#, actually. Hold on, let's get rid of that. These are just C#, so you can just write some C# to do whatever you want. And if you want to know how to actually use the Undertale mod tools code, you just have to download the source version, and you can open it in Visual Studio and browse and see all of the different tools that you have available to you. It also helps to look at some scripts that have already been made so that you have a basic idea, a basic baseline understanding of how they work internally. But really, these scripts are going to save you a lot of time, and in the next video, I'll show you one that I've been working on for quite some time, which is going to be useful for creating patches, which can be used to distribute your mod. For now, though, I'm going to be calling that a video. I hope you gained some information, some insight out of that. If this video helped you, like and subscribe.